Welcome to the Pearson Test of English, also known as PTE. This is the listening section and the last question that is to be discussed. The question is write from dictation. The test format is as follows. You will be given 3 to 4 items. The skills assessed are listening and writing. The marks allotted are as follows. You will be given 1 mark each for correctly spelled words. The prompt length is between 3 to 5 seconds. Here is a sample of what the listening task, specifically write from dictation, looks like. As you can see, your instruction has been given at the very beginning. It says that you will hear a sentence and you have to type the sentence in the box below exactly as you hear it. Write as much of the sentence as you can. You will hear the sentence only once. This is your audio status box, which shows when the sentence is beginning. This is the volume and here is your progress bar. You have to listen to the recording. Once it stops, you have to type it down into this particular box. Try to write as many words as possible. They should be grammatically correct. So, what is the task about? You will listen to the recording of a sentence. At the same time, you will have to type or write the sentence as you hear it. Now, I've mentioned write here because during practice, you could write down in your notebook. Now, the sentences will be played only once. The purpose of the task is to test how well you can listen, comprehend, and reproduce that information in writing. In the test, you will be typing it onto the screen. That is why there are 2 skills assessed here, listening and writing. Now, these are some of the strategies that you could follow to do this task effectively. First, place the cursor on the text box so that you don't lose out on the words and you follow it simultaneously and you are ready for it. Now, watch the on-screen progress indicator. Note down the content of words on the notebook booklet. You may also type directly as fast as you can. Start with a capital letter. All the sentences that you write should start with capital letters. Make sure you put a full stop at the end of it. If the speaker in the recording mentions the name of a city or cities or a person, make sure you write those in capital letters because capitalization rules will be applied, especially when it comes to starting a sentence. At times, there might be a slight pause, so don't get confused or lose focus. You won't be given specifically any dates per se, but try not to write in numeral form, even if you are given. Contractions are to be typed as they are dictated. If the speaker says don't, then you must write D-O-N apostrophe T. Do not convert it and write as did not. Next, your spelling must be correct and the words must be in the correct order. Otherwise, this will affect the entire structure of the sentence. Punctuation is extremely important. You must use correct punctuation. If the sentence you hear is a question, then make sure you put a question mark at the end of it. The word before the wrong punctuation is also marked incorrect, so you have to be extremely careful. Focus on comprehending the meaning of the sentence. If you forget a few words, try to write down whatever you can remember and see how they fit grammatically and write down your answer. You will now hear some practice questions. You will listen to 2 audios. You will hear these sentences. You have to write each sentence exactly as you hear it. Write as much of each sentence as you can. You will hear each sentence only once. So be prepared. Now, listen to the audio.
Practice Test 1, page 46, section 2. Write from dictation. You will hear some sentences. Write each sentence exactly as you hear it. Write as much of each sentence as you can. You will hear each sentence only once.
Hundreds of scientific papers have been published on global warming.
Political power only disappears when this stage has been completed.
Social networks are changing the way we communicate.
The cotton industry purchased all its raw cotton from abroad.
Practice Test 1, page 47. Further practice and guidance. Listen to the recordings while reading the transcriptions. Circle the words in the transcription that do not match the recording.
One way to think about voltage is to imagine it as the pressure that pushes charges along a conductor.
The electrical resistance of a conductor would then be a measure of the difficulty of pushing those charges along.
Now, if we use an analogy of water flowing in a pipe, a long, narrow pipe resists flow more than a short, fat one does. A long, narrow one has more resistance.
Currents work in the same way. Long, thin wires have more resistance than do short, thick wires.
Conversely, short, fat wires have less resistance.
Some of the most common problems that occur in this particular question are as follows. Number one, inability to follow accents. A lot of students struggle with this, so make sure you listen to different accents via movies or videos or music, etc. Next thing that people struggle with is difficulty in remembering the words. Sometimes the speaker might be very, very fast, and this is again directly connected to the inability to understand accents. The next problem is the inability to follow the word order. As mentioned before, you must write the correct order of the words that you hear. And finally, spelling, grammar, and punctuation errors. It is a sentence after all, and the skills assessed here are listening and writing. Therefore, all writing rules will apply. Now, here are some tips that you can practice. First, follow the oral sequencing of information. When you're practicing, try listening to different sentences or speeches and see how you are able to match up to that level and see how much you can follow. It is suggested that you practice speed typing. Identify nouns, adjectives, adverbs, and verbs while listening. So this forms a major chunk of the sentence. And if you manage to identify all of this, then what you can do is use articles, prepositions, conjunctions to bring it into a grammatical structure. Next, learn homophones. There are a lot of words which sound very similar, like see and see. So try to identify the meaning of the words while listening to it. Practice proper sentence framing. This is extremely important. Practice grammatical structures and punctuation. Take out time, at least half an hour, and practice 10 to 15 sentences every day. Now, try to identify different memory techniques. The best thing would be to use whatever works best for you. Try to associate the words with certain things that you have seen, either on television or in your personal experience, etc. Try to write the maximum number of words that you remember. That is the end of this particular section. Thank you. Good luck with your practice.